Welcome to Daniel Reviews. I'm Daniel Goodwin. Today we are talking about 3D printing. A little over a year ago, I did a review of the Bambu Labs P1S 3D printer, and I wanted to do a lot more content on it, but I just had so many other things I didn't come back to it. But rest assured, I've been printing with it almost every day for the last year, and I am still just as enthusiastic about the printer as I was the day I got it. It is the 3D printer that you are looking for. For the most part, I haven't had any issues with it. It's just worked. It's been very seamless. It's been just, you know, it's not quite to the level of a paper printer where you just click print and it's done, but it's as close as I've ever seen, and I absolutely love it. Still strongly recommend it. It's incredible. I want to talk today about changing the hot end. I'm going to show you how you can do that. And then I want to talk a little bit about why you would do that and what benefits you might get versus what trade-offs you might have. About a month ago, it's mid-December, right before Christmas, I did have a catastrophic print failure on the P1S. And what happened was I was doing a multicolor print, which generates lots of, they call them little poops, where they purge the excess filament that they're not using out the back. While I was running it, it was a super long print. I checked on it before I went to bed. It looked like there was plenty of room in the bin that I had behind it to collect all that. And when I came back in the morning, it had greatly exceeded what I thought would be a reasonable amount of space, filled up the whole container, backed up the chute, and kind of just wrapped around the print head. So it was just terrible. I almost saved it all. I was able to get a lot of it off, but I accidentally damaged the little thermistor that measures the nozzle temperature. So I needed to get a replacement hot end assembly, and so that's what I did. I recommend definitely having a spare hot end, complete hot end assembly on hand, just in case something like this happens to you. It's fairly easy to fix, and you can be back up and running in just a few minutes. But if you don't have the part, you gotta wait for shipping. They might be back ordered and who knows what. So it's good to have a couple of these on hand just in case. With that said, let's get right into switching out the hot end. Today we're replacing the hot end of the Bambu P1S. I actually have on it right now the 0.6 millimeter hot end. I had an issue with it with my previous hot end, and I had to replace it. And unfortunately at the time, all that Bambu had available was the 6 millimeters or 0.6 millimeter. So I put that on and I've been running with it for about a month, and I don't dislike it, but I really like the 0.4 better for the quality. And so I'm going to replace it with the 0.4 millimeter. Just going to remove these screws. There's two screws that hold it in with this extremely long hex wrench, which is very useful. You just pull those out. And then the complete hot end assembly connects these two ribbons here. This is for the cover of it. I'm just going to go ahead and pull that apart because I don't want it to be in the way. So I'm going to go ahead and take that off. And then there's these two as well. I'm going to take those two apart from there. And then the whole, I'm just going to slide, the whole thing should just kind of come out. Yep. There we go. So this is the complete hot end assembly. You can see it's the 0.6. Again, it's not that I disliked it. It's just that the 0.4 gives just a little better quality on the prints. Slower, but it's a little bit better. And so I'm going to take this out and replace it with the 0.4. Here is the 0.4. It comes as a complete hot end assembly from Bambu. You do want to be careful and make sure that you order the complete assembly. I messed up when I originally ordered and bought just the hot end by itself, and that's actually kind of a real pain because you have to swap out the thermistor and everything in there that measures the temperature of the hot end. So you just don't want to do that. You want to just get the whole assembly, so it's a very easy swap. All right, so we're going to go ahead and slide this in. We're going to try to carefully thread these cables up. We're going to try to, first we're going to take this one by one and thread the cable through this little catch on the side, because it's kind of difficult to do
then we're going to put the second one through and slide it over. Great. And then now we're going to try to get this hot end up in there. It just kind of slides up until it seats. It was a little to the left. So now they should go in there. There we go. That definitely goes in a lot better. And so does this one. So we'll just tighten those up. Alternate between the screws to make sure that they're snugging down evenly on the hot end. Make sure it's very snug because you don't want anything coming loose or wearing loose over time. There we go. It says it's all ready to print. The last thing we're going to do is go over to the computer and do a calibration to make sure that it prints well.
Okay, so we're back in Bambu Lab Studio. This step, in theory, you probably don't need to do this if you're putting on a 0.4 millimeter head because it's already pretty well aligned for that. But it's still, probably still best to do. Now, if you're swapping out to something like a 0.6 or 0.8 or something else, then you definitely are going to want to do this. But what you do is you get into Bambu Studio, you go over to the calibration. Well, first, when you go to your device, let me just show you something on that. You're going to go to your printer parts, and you're going to make sure you set this to be what your new setting was. So in this case, I put on a 0.4, but previously I had a 0.6 on there. You're going to want to set that there. Then you're going to come here and do the manual calibration first on the flow dynamics. Here you're going to set what diameter nozzle you're going to use. We're going to use the textured PEI plate. We have our ones to do. There's a couple options here. You can do a line method where it does several lines and looks at it, or you can do a pattern. That's just personal preference. A line's going to use a lot less filament, be pretty quick. Pattern's going to be a little bit different, you know, so you can do that. The other thing you're going to want to run is the flow rate calibration. It's a very similar step. It's going to do several different little plates that you will then inspect and compare which one has the best quality. All right, now we have our printed calibration plate, and you can see pretty much zero is dead on. All the others have an amount of imperfection to them, whereas in zero is pretty much probably the best of the batch, certainly better than the these here at the top. So I think probably we'll want it at either zero or maybe five. I feel like zero is better, certainly better than the others. Just trying to compare these two a little closer. I mean, they're really close. I feel like five almost. I mean, I might be second guessing this a little too much. All right, we just printed the second set, and honestly, this is looking pretty good too. So it's going to be a little tricky to figure out exactly which one looks perfect, but we'll try to do our best. The number one reason why you would move up to a 0.6 millimeter or larger nozzle is to speed up your prints. Obviously, 3D printing takes a lot of time. That's not everyone who's gotten into it realizes that. And by going to a larger diameter nozzle, you can speed that up. Now, the result is that, let me see if I can find an example. Your lines, I don't know if this will show up very well, but your lines will be more noticeable and prevalent on your prints. Even if you select a smaller layer size, it's going to be more noticeable than say the 0.4. The positive is that you get a faster print time, and it might be, depending on your own personal preferences, might be at a good enough quality that you're like, you know what, I just want the faster print time. I don't care that I can see the lines a little more clearly than I can with a smaller nozzle. I just want to speed things up. The great thing with Bambu Lab Studio is you can actually see how much of a difference the bigger nozzles will make on your print right there in the lab. So I'll show you how to do that.
So for example, I have a print project here. This is a pill box, pretty straightforward. I've sliced it, and basically the print time, if I can, it tells me right here that the entire thing would take about 2 hours and 53 minutes to run on a 0.4 nozzle at 0.20 standard size. Great, I know all that. Well, you can go to your device here by clicking this little gear icon. It takes a second, but eventually it'll show up, and you can find your P1S, and you can choose which nozzles you want to kind of have on there as an option. So if you got the really big 0.8 millimeter, you could put that on there, or the 0.2, whatever. It basically lets you select between those profiles. So again, 2 hours, 53 minutes with the 0.4. Let's switch to the 0.6 nozzle, slice it. This is going to be the 30 millimeter, which is kind of like the standard for the 0.6. And you can see that the total print time is only 2 hours and 45 minutes. So it made not a very big difference in the overall print time. And I'm going to a larger line size than on the 0.4. Now, obviously, I can really take this up. I can go all the way to 0.42 and slice it. And, you know, that's going to shave off 15 minutes, which might be good, but I'm telling you that the print quality is going to not be as good. And that's kind of the trade-off that you're making. There's some other things you could do here with the speed and all that might impact this, but I don't recommend making those changes.
So in closing, I've been running with the 0.6 millimeter for the past month. I did finally get the 0.4 millimeter. They had it back in stock. I got that. And I am swapping back to use the 0.4 millimeter because for me, the 0.4 gives just a little bit better quality overall, and I didn't think that the increased or decreased print times with the 0.6 were that advantageous that it made sense. Now, I'm sure I'm going to miss it a little bit, because it was kind of nice churning out some things pretty fast, particularly when you really opened up the quality and used the largest layer size you could. But the other thing is, even though you're using a larger layer size, the printer actually moves slower because it's still trying to force a kind of a fixed amount of plastic through the whole, extruder into the hot end and out onto your print bed. It's kind of like one of those things where, yes, you get a little bit of an advantage, but it's not night and day. It's not blinding fast. And yeah, you can adjust some parameters and maybe tweak some things, but honestly, that's not why you get this printer. This printer you get because it is fire and forget. You don't have to mess with all those things. You don't have to tweak those things. You can if you want to. If you geek out on that, go for it. But for most people, this is a printer that they just don't have to be involved in that process. And so if you're one of those persons and you're thinking, I'd like to increase my or speed up my print times, I'm okay with some quality, issues. The 0.6 or even the 0.8 may make sense for you. And it's, that part is not hard to swap out and use. So hopefully this video was useful for you. Again, I feel like the 0.4, and you can see it in Bambu Lab Studio. You can take whatever print you have, compare the 0.4 to a 0.6 or even a 0.8 as far as the print time, and kind of like use that to understand whether or not it's worth making that swap out for you. For me, it wasn't. For you, it might. But I did want you to know that's an option. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.